Welcome back to our channel. Today, we're going to take you on a journey to the amazing and innovative floating airport. Have you ever heard of a floating airport? Well, in Japan, they've taken airport innovation to new heights. Or rather, new depths. This incredible engineering feat has taken the world by storm, and we can't wait to show you why. Welcome to Kansai International Airport. A marvel of engineering that's floating on the waters of Osaka Bay. Osaka Kansai Airport is a spectacular construction, located on an artificial island in the middle of Osaka Bay, 38 kilometers southwest of Osaka Station. It was opened in 1994 and expanded in 2007. As you can imagine, construction was no easy task. Two mountains were flattened to build the island, and, according to the Institution of Civil Engineers, at the time of its completion, it was the most expensive civil engineering project to date. In the 1960s and 70s, some key events led to the construction of the airport. Firstly, Osaka and Kobe were losing trade and business to Tokyo. Tokyo's second airport, Narita, was proposed as early as 1966 and opened in 1978. Many exporters had to ship cargo to Tokyo rather than use the local airport. Secondly, the existing airport, Itami, was starting to prove inadequate. Itami Airport is located in a densely populated suburb of Osaka. It opened in 1939. And was initially used by the Japanese Army, and then the US military, after the end of the Second World War. It was converted for civilian use and expanded from 1959, and soon became a central hub for international airlines. Aviation, of course, has expanded significantly since then, and the airport has not been able to accommodate the demand. With the urban area around it, there was no room for expansion. Problems with noise and local objection did not help either. By the 1970s, it was already reaching capacity, and it was clear a new airport location was needed. An artificial island was not the first choice. The initial plan was to build the new airport close to Kobe. This could serve both cities easily with fast transport links, and Kobe did not have an airport of its own. The city of Kobe, however, rejected these plans, and airport planners were forced to look at other locations. Learning from the problems faced at Itami, planners wanted a location away from built-up areas. This would allow large-scale construction and 24-hour operation. They had also seen the problems faced in Tokyo with the planning of Narita Airport. In the 1960s, there were objections and protests by both residents and landowners, who claimed they were not consulted in the process, as well as left-wing political parties, who objected to the promotion of capitalism and potential alliances with the US. Following consideration of six offshore sites by the Ministry of Transportation, a proposal was made to construct an artificial island in Osaka Bay, to the south of the city. This would be 4 kilometers long, 2.5 kilometers wide, and 5 kilometers offshore. The airport would require extensive, sophisticated engineering, both to construct and to ensure it could withstand flooding, typhoons, and earthquakes. This proposal was approved. Construction started in 1987. The seawall was finished in 1989. Made of rock and 48,000 tetrahedral concrete blocks. 10,000 workers and 10 million work hours over 3 years, using 80 ships, were needed to complete the 30-meter layer of earth over the sea floor and inside the sea wall. In 1990, a 3-kilometer bridge was completed to connect the island to the mainland at Rinku Town, at a cost of $1 billion. Completion of the artificial island increased the area of Osaka Prefecture, just enough to move it past Kagawa Prefecture in size, leaving Kagawa as the smallest by area in Japan. A significant part of the airport design and construction focused on protection from Japan's extreme weather events. A major test of this came with the Kobe earthquake in January 1995. Also known as the Great Hanshin Earthquake, this was Japan's worst earthquake since 1923. And left more than 6,000 people dead. The epicenter was about 20 kilometers away from the airport. Despite extensive damage to buildings at a similar distance, the airport was almost undamaged. This success is attributed to the use of sliding joints in all airport building construction. It has also coped well with several typhoons over the years, including an extreme one in 1998. With winds of over 210 kilometers per hour. This lasted until 2018 when Typhoon Jebi hit the airport. This was the strongest typhoon to hit Japan since 1993, and it caused extensive damage across the Kansai region. Waves broke over the airport walls and flooded the runways, and a tanker damaged the bridge. Full operations at the airport did not start again for nearly a month. Although this was an extreme weather event, it again started a discussion about the problems with the airport and how it was sinking closer to sea level. Despite some incredible engineering successes and proven ability to withstand earthquakes and typhoons, issues are now appearing. Notably, the island is sinking faster than expected, leading to increasing problems with flooding. Since the time of its conception, the issue of the further sinking of Kansai Airport has been a major one. Its foundations are on a thick layer of clay, and predictions vary regarding how much it will sink. The sand drain method used to strengthen the seafloor would result in further sinking, as the still wet sand compressed under the weight. The weight of the airport and aircraft, of course, is nowhere near as significant as the vast mass of stone making up the island. A study in the Journal of Geotechnical and Geo-Environmental Engineering in 2015 looked at how much the airport had sunk. The airport design specification was that it should reach a minimum level of 4 meters above sea level, which should still prevent flooding if the seawall is damaged. This report shows that the first island had already reached this level by 2015, and the second island was predicted to do so between 2023 and 2026. Furthermore, the two islands would reach sea level by 2067 and between 2058 and 2100, respectively. The problem is due simply to a difference between the planning engineer's estimates and the sinking rate that has occurred in reality. A further concern, highlighted by Air and Space magazine, is the unequal sinking at different parts of the airport. At the center of the main terminal on the first island, for example, a higher sinking rate is being measured than at the ends of the building. Previously, this was experienced at other locations. To prevent damage or cracking, the airport runways were repaved with asphalt rather than concrete. What can be done? Of course, the actual rate of further sinking may turn out to be different from what is estimated now, just as the original estimate did. The risk with further sinking is that as it approaches sea level, any storms or typhoons are more likely to cause water to break over the seawall and engulf the airport. There is little that can be done to change this fundamentally, but the construction does allow for some minimizing of damage and disruption. One option is to raise the seawall further. This has been done once, at significant expense, and there are plans to raise it further. According to the Straits Times, a 3-year project began in 2019 to further raise the seawalls. The other protection is the ability to raise the buildings. The foundation columns can be adjusted, as discussed previously, by inserting metal plates to offset the sinking. According to Air and Space magazine's reporting, this takes place every 2 years, with each of the columns checked and adjusted as necessary. That's all for this video on Japan's floating airport. We hope you enjoyed it and learned something new. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them in the comment section below. And don't forget to like and subscribe to our channel for more exciting content.